Now student, open page number 30. The topic is comparison of rational numbers. In this concept, we will understand how can we compare rational numbers. To find the comparison of rational number, we follow these steps. Number 1, find the LCM of denominator of a given rational number. Then, rewrite the rational numbers with a common denominator. After that, compare the numerators and arrange rational numbers in ascending or descending order. The most important thing which we remember here is the fraction having greater numerator is larger. The fraction having greater numerator is larger. Through this concept, we will define which number is greater, which rational number is greater, and which one is smaller or less than. Further, I will explain this topic through questions. Now, open page number 33, exercise 2.3, question number 1. There is 12 parts and I have selected here 7 parts for you. You can see here, first term is 5 by 7. And minus other rational number is minus 1 by 2. The question is, put the correct sign greater than, less than, or equal to between pairs of rational numbers. So, first of all, what should we do? We will make their denominator equal. You can see here, there is 7 and 2. They are different denominator. To find the comparison, we must have same denominator. For this purpose, I have to take an LCM and I got, you can see here, 14 as a common number, common LCM here, 14. So, I will take first fraction, which is first rational number, which is 5 by 7. 7 is my denominator and I have to convert this 7 into 14. So, I will find the number, how many times I will multiply 7 by any number and I got 14. So 7, 2 times 14, you can see here, 14. To make the equation or to make our fraction rational number equivalent, what should we do? We will multiply with the same number with our numerator. We will multiply our numerator with same number by which we multiply our denominator. You can see I will multiply my denominator by 2 to get 14. So 5 must be multiplied with 2 as well. So finally I got this rational number 10 by 14. Same process I will repeat here. My rational number is minus 1 by 2. 2 how many times 14? 7 times. So I will multiply my 2 denominator by 7 and my numerator by 7 as well. So finally I got 7 by 14. Here one rational number is positive and one is negative. You know it very well. Every negative number is having less value as compared to positive number. So finally positive number considered greater and negative number always having a less value, so it is smaller. I will write this comparison in this way. 10 by 14 is greater than minus 7 by 14. This is my solution. And I will put my comparison or a symbol sign in my question as well. So 5 by 7 is greater than minus 1 by 2. Is it clear, students? Through this process, this method which we apply here, we can solve our question number 2 and 3 of exercise 2.3. The same process, same method we will apply in these two questions as well. For example, I have taken one question as an example for you. I have solved it here for you. You can understand it very easily. I have three fractions here, three rational numbers, 1 by 2, 2 by 3 and 7 by 18. You can see here all denominators are different. So whenever we want to find the comparison, we want to find arrange our rational numbers in descending order or ascending order, we must have same denominator. For this purpose, I will take LCM and through LCM, I got 24 as a common denominator. Now finally, I will take first rational number, which is 1 by 2. I will find a number by which I will multiply 2 by it, and I got 24. So 2, how many times 24? 12 times. I will multiply 2 by 12, and same number must be multiplied with our numerator to make our rational number equivalent. In this process, we will get 12 by 24 here. Same process will be repeated in our second term and in our third term. There are 3 how many times? 8 times 24. Here, both numerator and denominator must be multiplied by 8. And in this case, 8 how many times? 3 times 24. So you can see here, numerator and denominator, both parts must be multiplied by 3. Finally, I got 12 by 24, 16 by 24, and 21 by 24. As in the rule I have told you, a fraction having greater numerator is larger, is considered bigger. So 21 is a numerator which is greater. So this is a larger one. We will write, arrange them in this way. I am arranging my terms, my rational number in descending order. The 21 is greater, 16 is less than 21, and 12 is less than 16. So students, finally I get 21 by 24, 16 by 24, 12 by 24, and I arrange them in descending order here. And this is the, my change numbers, and the question is 1 by 2, 2 by 3, and 7 by 8. I will arrange my question, these rational numbers, in descending order. First of all, 7 by 8, then 2 by 3, and then 1 by 2 are written in the form of descending order. Again, I can repeat whole this process, all these steps, to arrange my question, to arrange my rational number into ascending order. Same method we will apply here. Nothing changed. Ascending means smaller to greater. So the smallest number here is 12, 12 by 24. So I will arrange 1 by 2 first, then 2 by 3, and then 7 by 8. Remember, in ascending order, we will arrange our rational number smaller than greater, and in descending order we will arrange greater to smaller. So in this way, through this process, through these steps, we can arrange easily our rational numbers in descending and ascending order. Now student, open page number 28. There is another topic, which is properties of rational numbers. Properties. This is not new concept for you. Sometimes we use the word properties, sometimes we use the word laws. So what are the main properties? There are three main properties. Well, number one is commutative property, associative property, and distributive property. Basically, the purpose of this property is this: whenever we want to solve the question and change the order of the terms, the answer cannot be affected. These properties tell us that if we are adding the numbers, multiply the number, then we will change the order of the terms. The answer cannot be affected. So we will solve properties of rational numbers here. Number one property is commutative property. There are two parts or two kinds. Number one is commutative property of rational numbers with respect to addition. It means that commutative properties can hold addition. Whenever I have a two, you can see here, rational numbers. Number one is P by Q and R by S, and I want to add them. And if I want to change the order of the terms, this is my left hand side and this is right hand side. You can see here, there is P by Q first, and on the other side R by S written first. So if the order of the term changed, answer cannot be affected. Answer remains same. In commutative properties, we have always two terms, two rational number, two terms. There is, you can see, 1 and 2, A and B. There are two terms. So what is the second step or kind of this? Commutative property of rational numbers with respect to multiplication. It means that commutative property can hold on multiplication as well. In multiplication, whenever we have two rational numbers, and if we change the order of these rational numbers, answer cannot be effected. And through this formula you can understand very easily. First I have written here P by Q, but on the other side I have written R by S. But if I multiply them, answer remains same. For example, 3 multiply by 2, 6, and 2 multiply by 3, always 6. So through these two types we can understand easily what is commutative property and how we will solve them. We will apply the same rule which we have learned in operations of rational number. If we want to add them, you know it very well how we will add the rational number. You want to multiply, you know it very well how to multiply the rational number. So the method is same, but only these property tells us that if the order of the terms change, answer cannot be affected. Clear now? Now the second property is associative property. In this property we have three terms and same sign with terms. Look at here, associative property of rational number with respect to addition. It means that associative property apply and holds addition. You can see through this formula very clearly. There are three different terms, P by Q, R by S and T by U. And between them we have a same sign, plus and plus. This is my left hand side. On the right hand side you can see I will put P by Q first and then in a bracket I will take R by S plus T by U. So you can see if I change the order of the terms, there is first I will solve bracket, in other hand I will solve bracket and then I will solve P by Q with it. Na? So you can see if the order of the terms change, answer cannot be affected. This is the associative property of addition. Now the second type is associative property of rational numbers with respect to multiplication. So it means that associative property can apply on multiplication as well. As I have told you, in the associative property always we have three terms and the same sign between them. Now we were discussing the multiplication. So here P by Q multiply by R by S. First I will take these two terms in the bracket. But on other side, you can see that R by S and T by U is taken in bracket. So if the order is changed, answer cannot be affected. In the associative property, we have three terms, same sign between them. And if we change the order of the term, answer cannot be affected. Clear now? Now the third property is distributive property of multiplication over addition and subtraction. In this property, distributive property of multiplication, we will multiply one rational number with other two numbers. But sometimes we have the relation between other two numbers are addition, and sometimes we have a subtraction between the two numbers. Look at here, I will explain through this example. You can see here, P by Q is a first rational number and it is multiply other two numbers. And what is the relation between other two rational numbers? There is a sign of addition which shows us both numbers must be added. So there are two ways to solve the question. Number one is this, on my left hand side. This is a way. First of all, I will solve my bracket and then I will multiply my sum with this rational number. On other side, you can see that there is another way to solve the question. First of all, P by Q is multiplying by R by S, and in other bracket P by Q again multiply T by U. Now in this case, first we will solve our brackets according to our rule, and after that we will get the product and then add them. So in this property we can see that if we will change the order of the term, you can see here right hand side and left hand side, change the order of the term, answer cannot be affected. The other type is, again we multiply one rational number with other two numbers, but what is the difference? There you can see in the bracket the relation of these two rational numbers is subtraction. So first we will subtract the numbers and then we will multiply our difference with this rational number. So if I will change the order of the terms, a sequence of the terms in this way, you can see here on the right hand side, the answer cannot be affected. So through these three properties, we can easily explain our rational numbers. Now, student, after explaining the properties on Rasana first, open your page number 33, exercise 2.3. Question number 4, which is proof that. In this question, we will solve our question according to our properties and get our answer equal on both sides. This is our left hand side, this is our right hand side. And after solving it, our answer of these two sides must be equal. So start our solution. In this way, you can see here there are three terms, but the sign between the number terms are different. So it means it is a distributive property. How? You can see here 5 by 8 is negative term, but it is multiplying with other two rational numbers, and the relation of other two rational numbers is subtraction. They are subtracting. So you can see, first of all, according to our rules, we will solve our bracket. After solving my bracket, what we should solve it through making our denominator equal. So there is a 7 and 3, they are different denominator, and the common LCM, and I will take the LCM, the common number is 21. So according to the rule which I have told you and we will learn before this exercise, you can see what should we do. 21 is a common element, common denominator. 7, how many times 21? 3 times. So 3 must be multiplied by 4 by our numerator, and then finally 3 times 4, 12. So there is 12. Same process will be replied here. 3, how many times 21? 7 times. So 7 will be multiplied with numerator, and finally I got 14. Between them there is a sign of subtraction. So I will subtract my terms. But you can see here the 14 is greater as compared to 12, and 14 having a negative sign. So when we will solve it, we will put the sign of greater term with our answer. Finally, minus 2 by 21. What should we do? I will open my bracket and I solve the sign first. Minus minus plus. Both terms having a negative sign. First I will solve my sign. Minus minus plus. Now these 5 by 8 and 2 by 21 I will return in the form of, in this way, the bracket. And finally I will apply the rule of multiplication here. 2 and 8 are even numbers. They can be cancelled by the number 2. So 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8. And finally 5 multiplied with numerator and this denominator multiplied by denominator, and I got 5 by 84. On the right hand side, the terms are same, but the order of the terms are changed. So in this case, in the bracket we have a number 5 by 8 and it is multiplying with 4 by 7. So according to our rule, we will multiply our numbers, our rational numbers. 4 and 8 are the factor of 4, so 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. I will simplify them by cancelling, and then finally I get minus 5 by 14. Same process I will apply on the other side, or other in the other bracket. Here you can see here there is a sign of multiplication. I will apply my rules of multiplication here. 2 and 8 are even numbers. They can be cancelled by 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8. And finally numerator multiplied by numerator, denominator multiplied by denominator. These are all same process and method which we have learned in our previous classes as well. So in the bracket there is a sign of subtraction, and outside there is also a sign of subtraction. When I will open my bracket, minus minus plus, minus minus plus. So again there is a sign of addition between them. What should we do? We will add the numbers. So for adding and subtracting the rational number, we know very well we must have a same denominator. For this purpose, I will taking the LCM and getting the same number, which is 84, as a common denominator. You know it very well how to take the LCM. Again, 14, how many times? 6 times. And 6 will be multiplied by numerator, sign remains same, it must be 30. Same process I will repeat here. 12, how many times? 7 times. 7 5s are 35. It is positive number, it is negative number. So plus minus minus. I will subtract it, I will get 5 by 84. As you know that So if 35 is greater and it is positive sign with it, so in our answer we will write the positive sign. So you can see through this question very easily that both sides, left hand side and right hand side, are equal here. It is proved that left hand side equal to right hand side. This is our way to solve the question. There are other parts in this question and you can solve it very easily.